Hello, I'm Jungsoo Lee from KAIST AI, and I will talk about our ICCV paper, Standardized Mixed Logits, accepted as an oral presentation. We addressed the problem of identifying unexpected and anomalous obstacles in urban scene segmentation. I co-worked with Sanghun, another first author of this work, Daehoon Gwak, Sungha Choi, and Professor Jaegul Choo. We will first explain the motivation of our work. A given pre-trained segmentation model always predicts all the pixels with the predefined classes used for training. However, this could be problematic when the segmentation model confronts unexpected obstacles which were not observed during the training phase. For example, in the image, the boxes and the dog are examples of unexpected obstacles. However, as shown in the image, the model predicted such anomalies as one of the predefined classes, which is road in this case. This causes the autonomous vehicle to hit the boxes and dog, which could harm the safety significantly. In order to handle such an issue, we tried to identify the anomalous pixels of unexpected obstacles, which may work as the starting point of handling such obstacles differently. Back to the previous example, this allows the autonomous vehicle to stop the car or circumvent such obstacles after detecting them. Now, let me talk about the previous work on this topic. Maximum softmax probability, or MSP in short, is widely used for identifying the out-of-distribution samples. However, it suffers from overconfident problem. In order to overcome the issue, another work proposed to use the values before the softmax function for the anomaly detection, which is termed as the max logits. The two plots visualize the anomaly scores of pixels of in-distribution and out-of-distribution. By addressing the overconfident problem, max logit decreased the gray regions, which indicate the overlapping regions of in-distribution pixels and out-of-distribution pixels, improving the detection capability overall. However, we found that the distribution of each class in the max logit significantly differs from each other in the urban scene segmentation. Since we utilize a single threshold for the evaluation, aligning these differently formed distributions to have the same mean and variance improves the detection capability. We call such a method as standardized max logits, SML in short. By applying the SML, we further decrease the gray regions. Let me switch gears and talk about the summary of our proposed method. Our method is composed of three steps. First, we standardize the max logits by using the mean and variance obtained from the training samples. Then, we suppress the boundary regions since the boundary regions have relatively low SML scores. Finally, we remove the irregulars which work as noises by using the Gaussian smoothing kernel. Let's take a closer look at each step. For the first step, SML, we calculate the mean and variance of each class from the training set. Then, by using the statistics obtained from the training set, we standardize the max logits during the inference stage. Then, we performed the iterative boundary suppression. We found that the boundary regions have lower SML since the boundary regions are where the classes change from one to another. In the second column of the image, the white pixels indicate the predicted anomalies. We can observe that the boundary regions are still identified as anomalies. Therefore, we iteratively suppress these regions in order to increase the SML values by using the so-called boundary-aware pooling, BAP in short. we first obtain the non-boundary masks from the segmentation predictions. Then, we average pull the SML values by applying the non-boundary masks. We repeat this process iteratively and update the SML values. However, this is not enough. We found that there still exist irregular pixels remaining which may work as noises. In order to mitigate this issue, we apply Gaussian smoothing, which is effective in removing small noises. Additionally, we set the dilation rate of the Gaussian smoothing as 7 in order to reflect the broad context of images. Now, let me talk about the quantitative evaluation of our work. We achieved the state-of-the-art performance of Fishescape's Lost and Found dataset. We want to emphasize that our method does not require additional training or extra OD data, which were necessary for most of the previous methods. Such a result is also available on the Fishescape's leaderboard. We also outperformed the baseline models on the validation datasets of Fishescape's and the Road Anomaly, another dataset used in this field. In addition to the quantitative evaluation, we conducted an in-depth analysis of our work. First, we conducted an ablation study on our modules. We confirmed that applying SML outperforms max logit. Also, applying both the iterative boundary suppression and dilated smoothing on SML outperforms applying only one of the two modules. Second, we maintained a reasonable segmentation performance on Cityscape's validation set after detecting anomalous objects. While MSP and MaxLogit suffer from significant performance degradation in the segmentation performance after detecting the unexpected objects, ours shows only a minimal amount of performance drop. Third, our method can be applied to diverse backbones including MobileNet, ShuffleNet, and ResNet 50. We confirmed that our method improves the performance in the three different backbones. Fourth, our method requires only a minimal amount of computation costs. Synthesize and compare is an approach which leverages an image resynthesis model to detect anomalous objects. However, it requires a non-trivial amount of GFLOPs and inference time. On the other hand, our method shows only a marginal increase of GFLOPs and inference time compared to ResNet 101, the baseline model. Lastly, we also confirmed that applying SML is essential for applying the iterative boundary suppression and dilated smoothing. Applying the iterative boundary suppression and dilated smoothing without applying SML aggravates the performance. This table 7 emphasizes the importance of the standardization of the max logits. This slide visualizes the identified anomalies with the threshold of the true positive rate A at 95%. The white pixels indicate anomalous objects. We can see that MSP and max logits have a non-trivial amount of false positives, those which are in distribution pixels but colored white. However, our method decreases the false positive pixels significantly. In summary, such extensive quantitative and qualitative evaluations demonstrate the effectiveness of our method. We believe that our work inspires future researchers who want to conceive of methods which are simple, yet effective, to detect anomalous objects in urban scene segmentation. This is the end of our presentation. If you're interested in our work, please visit our booth online. Thank you for listening.